Hi, and welcome to a video that I put together for you to show you the OneLaunch Apps Library. The OneLaunch Apps Library is a place that you can go to find all sorts of little apps and widgets that you can pin to your OneLaunch Doc experience to open up and really make your life day-to-day digitally on your personal computer that much more convenient and productive. So first and foremost, let's find out where the OneLaunch Apps Library is. Please follow my cursor, my mouse, to the top left section of the OneLaunch dock, and it's the gray plus icon, the gray plus button. If you hover over it, it will say Additional Apps, and it's here where you can click to open up the Apps Library. So all of our OneLaunch installs come default with the dashboard app pre-pinned to your OneLaunch dock experience. And often as well, we'll pre-pin an app for you based on the marketing flow that you installed OneLaunch for. So often you'll have by default two apps already pre-pinned to your OneLaunch dock experience based on what you really wanted. But post-install, you're fully able to customize the experience completely, remove whatever apps and widgets you don't want, and add as many as you want. So just to start giving you a sense of what apps are all about, we can quickly look at the dashboard. I do another video on our YouTube channel completely on the dashboard, so I won't go into depth here, but you can see the dashboard is a place that has popular sites, a lot of info about the weather for the day, top news articles from MSN, and if you have bookmarks, all of your bookmarks kind of at your fingertips here in the dashboard app. So to add more, it's very, very simple. You can simply go through the apps library, scroll up and down, and click the apps that you want to try out and pin to your OneLaunch dock. So let me just show you a couple. Let's add OneLaunch, we'll add the wallpaper app to your dock. So you can see as soon as I clicked it, it populates and pins on the OneLaunch dock. Let's add maps, let's add weather, and let's add news. So at a certain point, there's just not a ton of room on the dock, so we do have an overflow section. I'll just show you what happens if I keep adding. So games, that triggered our overflow section, recipes, etc. You can see an animated flash to show you that they are being added. There's just no longer any room on the dock. And to show you where they go, there's a drop down at this point where games and recipes have gone. And then you can continue to manage apps. So let's just remove those. And then one other thing I wanted to show you is you're able to right click any of the apps to hide the label. So if you know what the icon means for an app in specific, you don't need that label any longer. So you can hide the label, and that took away the text that said dashboard. And what this does is opens up room for additional apps on the dock. So let's try to re-add games. Sure enough, there's room. Recipes, there's room. And now it's PDF. That has pushed us into overflow. So again, I'll just undo that and I'll add the label back to the dashboard app, right click, show label. So you can do that on any of these apps, but it's all dependent on how much space you want on your dock experience. So let's quickly go through a couple of some of my favorite apps, but maybe before I get into that, I can just kind of scroll up and down. We've got apps in all sorts of arenas of things you might do day to day on your computer, apps that give you classifieds in your area, all sorts of e-cards that you might need to send loved ones or friends or family, digital cards. We've got apps that take you to all the manuals you might need on the internet for different things in your home, like a fridge manual. We've got a calculator app, games app, recipe apps, PDF conversion apps, apps that give you all you need to know about your horoscopes and Chinese zodiacs, so all sorts of things that you're able to play around with. So yeah, just to go through a few, the wallpaper app, one of my favorites. We pull in all sorts of beautiful imagery for you that you can choose completely for free. Lots of different categories. Let's change to sports. And here I can choose this boxing background. A quick click and that will populate for me. It's a bit slow. I think my internet's a bit slow today, but that should populate quite quickly for you. And there it is. So behind me. So if it's something you didn't like, you're able to go back and simply click undo, and that will go right back to your prior wallpaper. So great app for all your wallpaper needs. The Maps app, this is where you're able to decide on routes and plan out routes and get directions to where you need to go. So let's say we want to go from New York. We're starting from New York to Seattle. Simply click Get Directions. And that opens up those directions for you immediately and quickly in your OneLaunch Chromium browser. So there's your directions from New York to Seattle via Google Maps. We've got a weather app for you that immediately shows you all the weather that you need to look at for the day. Lots of quick links, 5-day forecast, a news app for you. That again, lots of categories for you to sift through and choose: entertainment, local, shopping, money, gaming, general, always by default general, but lots of great news brought to you daily from MSN. I think I added after the mix just a calculator app if that's something you use often. So our apps marketplace is, or our apps library, sorry, is a place that has all sorts of convenient apps and widgets and features that you can add as you see fit. We're always adding more and more apps and widgets over time. So we'd love to hear if we're missing something that you'd like, and we'll add it as soon as we can. Just reach out to OneLaunch support via our website. Hope this was a great summary of where the apps library is and what types of things it entails, how to add apps to the dock and remove them, add the labels and remove the labels. Hope you enjoyed the video. Talk to you soon.